Europe isn't just a different continent. In some ways, it's a whole other world, chock full of unusual trends we may have never even heard of over here across the pond. The differences go far beyond language and culture. Many European customs and fashions are completely foreign to those of us living elsewhere. How many of these European trends would you try for yourself? Blackening. Once a nearly forgotten tradition, so-called blackening is now making a surprising comeback in Scotland. According to the Herald, the local tradition consists of the bride and groom being kidnapped by their friends and covered in substances such as flour, custard, or soot, and then sometimes finished off with feathers. Blackening is thought to bring good luck to the couple. The ritual can get a bit rough, especially when the kidnappers tie up the bride and groom as they are blackened. Hopefully, no wedding dresses are ruined in the process. Hygge. If you're unfamiliar with this Scandinavian term, here's the basic idea. According to the Oxford Dictionary, hygge is a Danish word meaning a quality of coziness and comfortable conviviality that engenders a feeling of contentment or well-being. Hygge is less of a trend and more of a lifestyle in Nordic countries. Mike Viking, the author of The Little Book of Hygge, told Time magazine, "It's something I grew up with, and is a central part of Danish culture and DNA. For us, it's not a lifestyle move, it's simply a way of living and how we do things."
It's about relaxation, it's about indulgence, it's about good food, it's about gratitude, it's about equality. All those things mixed together is hygge.
While the buzzword has become popular in the US via social media to describe all things warm, cozy, and indulgent, hygge is much more than a design aesthetic or dietary choice. Helen Russell, the author of The Year of Living Danishly, described hygge to Time as also the, quote, complete absence of anything annoying or emotionally overwhelming. No wonder hygge has started to catch on across the pond. Russafaring. In the United States, parties for high school graduates are pretty standard, but it's typically one big bash. Norway, however, takes graduation celebrations to a whole new level, with a tradition called russafaring. These blowouts last for an entire month, and graduating students consume more than their fair share of alcohol. Partying for an entire month takes its toll. Drunken injuries are common, though most aren't too serious. The older generations do not fully approve of the partying, but the still trendy tradition, which dates back to 1905, is tolerated. One russafaring participant told the Associated Press, "You're only allowed one time, so do it right when you graduate, because you never go back here. Never." Eyeball jewelry. Bored by tattoos, piercings, and other standard body mods? Eyeball jewelry just might be the thing for you, though we certainly don't recommend it. The so-called extraocular implant procedure, devised in the Netherlands, embeds a small piece of jewelry in your eyeball. It's mostly done in Europe, although there's at least one US doctor who has performed it, even though, according to ABC News, it isn't approved by the Food and Drug Administration. There's little chance that the trend will take off in the US, as the American Academy of Ophthalmology has urged people not to have the procedure done, warning of a slew of complications, including blindness. Slow TV. A recent fad in Norway, slow TV is sort of the visual equivalent of background music. Viewers aren't sitting riveted in front of their screens watching several hours of, say, people knitting. They're tuning in when they want to watch something intermittently that won't consume all of their attention, or hardly any of it. One slow TV producer admitted to CBS News that his brainchild is indeed boring.
Much of life itself, it's boring. But in between there are some excitement moments, and you just have to wait for them.
The genre has even made the jump to Netflix so that international audiences can experience this trend for themselves, if they can stay awake. Some of the Norwegian slow TV shows that can be found on Netflix include Train Ride, Bergen to Oslo, and A Gentle Journey Down the Telemark Canal, perfect for a Sunday afternoon nap. Thanks for watching. Click the list icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love, too.